Hi, in this material
I will explain you what is so-called core banking and what was the genesis of its creation or coining this abbreviation or term, and what implications or current situations is about it. So in 70s of 20th century, banks started or had servers in the branches, but ATM networks started to arrive and this kind of technology, networking technology, which caused a need to have like some system which could be handling those data from so-called centralized online real-time environment. And that's the abbreviation for CORE banking, so today
core banking.
Centralizing this data allowed customers to access their balance or money or status of their, let's say, accounts, transactions and so on, not only from the branch where they had the account, but from any other branches or ATMs. And later, when the internet started to spread, access to the accounts through internet banking, for example. So now we know the genesis of the term, centralized online real-time exchange environment. It's the genesis of the abbreviation, what is core banking. Now let's dive what actually core banking was and is today. So in business terms, core banking is the core traditional activity of banks. So maintaining deposits and granting loans or credits, then serving transactions, payments, the customers. And in IT system, the core banking systems usually had also these features or functionalities or domains served. So credit loans, these systems needed to be able to calculate the interest rates on credits, the installments and so on, handle transactions and calculate interest rates on deposits, and interface with other systems to, for example, settle card payments or settle wire transfers or other methods of payments. A common needed feature also would be like customer records, so having some records of the customer, like his personal data. So I will draw it here across as CR, so customer records, what's your name, what's your address and so on. That would form something which is the most traditional core banking system. Core banking system could be with or separated from general ledger system, which transactions and booking could happen or would be posted to. And for reporting purposes to regulators, contemporary or board of the bank and management staff, some like reporting features or reporting systems would emerge in cards, or as mentioned, payment integrations would emerge with years. And now you should have in mind that this technology flourished in 70s, 80s, 19th years of 20th century. So it often was built on so-called mainframes or IBM servers, written in COBOL, which nowadays is considered as, let's say, ancient technologies. And when internet was rising in popularity or mobile payments, then these systems were not designed for handling such traffic. It was assumed to be used by customers in branches, or then handling cards, but not to serving data for displaying them in internet banking or mobile banking. On the beginning of internet or mobile era, banks might be skeptic about adoption, potential adoption of these technologies. So it wouldn't make business sense to replace or try to redo this core existing banking technology. Just add some new channel. So a new online banking, for example, channel would be added, which had some, let's say, own database, built on more modern stack from 90s or beginning of 21st century. And this system would, let's say, cache data from the customers from this core banking to serve it to customers in the internet banking. If it could be from one vendor or the same, but it could be also from other, that when mobile phones reached adoption, it was served or bought another channel. And we have to remember that also there was the old channel of branches, which might be another application, and maybe something to handle customers through normal phone. So someone working in call center, and all these so-called channels would be either using the data from core banking system or replicating them in some way to serve them more efficiently to end customers. Within those most core banking system or old legacy systems, such concept is end of the day exist or cutoff hours. So hours till it takes, let's say, the orders for booking or transactions or making payments, and then it need to store or handle next part somewhere else, handle it somehow, because it needs time to calculate it. And the online, in the abbreviation, centralized real time online, in contemporary understanding was a bit exaggerated, not back in 70s or 80s, but in 21st centuries, you wouldn't probably name those systems as real time. And on online maybe, but not necessarily real time. Another problem with this most legacy core bankings is that they are built on old technologies, and people who know how to code in languages and technologies used back in 70s are getting close to retire or retiring, and contemporary coders are not too keen to learn those ancient technologies. It would be like learning ancient languages. Some people might like it, but most prefer to learn contemporary languages. The number of those systems grew with years, so I would speculate that banks, depending on the size, have from 50 up to 400 monolith systems within the IT landscape, and growth of number of systems complicate the architecture, obviously, and grows like the systematic risk, because too complex systems are just getting dangerous. How could it happen? Something like mergers and acquisitions. So if that doesn't look too complicated, imagine that some bank bought other bank and has all this stuff replicated and somehow migrated, maybe, but kept, for example, other core banking from the acquisited bank. Maybe the bank has actually not one, but more core or legacy systems, for example, for other business lines. So this could be, for example, retail banking core system, and here would be corporate or SME. Then, of course, more regulatory and other demands, like somewhere anti-money laundering systems, more strict KYC or customer due diligence systems, or some workflow systems to manage employees, and so on and so on. All these supporting systems might not necessarily replicate the data from core banking, but probably they use these data in their processes or need to read them, write them. So most of them will have some kind of interaction with this core banking, which again makes it hard to replace or modernize this core in the heart of a bank. That's it for today. I hope you know now where the core banking abbreviation comes from, what is it more or less, and what are the potential or existing problems with such systems. Let me know in comments below what else would you like to know about fintech, so IT in financial systems, banks or other kind of markets. And if you liked it, thumbs up, I will know whether to create next content like this one.